Okay, so the next topic that I want to talk about on this Hour of Kwonmunism is, let's do world news. I don't think I've done world news in a long time since I started doing Hour of Kwonmunism, whether that was because I didn't have time or I didn't have a topic to talk about. But in this edition, I do have a topic to talk about. I want to talk about gay marriage just recently passed in France, among some other countries like Uruguay, and what was the other country? I think it was New Zealand. But three new countries have now, I feel like it's New Zealand. I might be wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. But France, Uruguay, and New Zealand have just now approved and legalized gay marriage. And it's not without controversy. France in particular is a country where there's massive, I don't know if it's technically massive, but thousands of people, or about 1,000 people, rose up and did a protest against this, or did a rally of protesting the legalization of gay marriage after it's been legalized. And it was just their kind of reaction to this. So this is really interesting how, you know, considering it's, I feel like this gay marriage thing, gay marriage issue, campaign, and this fight for the legalization of gay marriage, it's becoming more and more widespread. I feel like the momentum is picking up, which, you know, if you know me, I am a big supporter of gay rights, and I am totally pro legalizing gay marriage. So this is good news. This is good news that is starting to have this momentum. Even in the United States, it's starting to have really great momentum. And next month, I think, is finally when we're going to start hearing from Supreme Court their decisions on Proposition 8 and DOMA, Defense of Marriage Act. Or not the entire act, but certain proponents of Defense of Marriage Acts. So that's going to be interesting to wait about. And also, quite recently, Delaware and a couple of other states just legalized gay marriage. And Illinois is just about to start to do so. And the debate is happening. So there is this momentum. It's not a big momentum. I still feel like, you know, at the rate we're going, it's still going to take until, like, I don't know, 2030 or 2050, till all states in America have legalized gay marriage and all European countries have legalized gay marriage. It's going to take 20 to 50 years at this rate. It's gonna speed up to at least get there somewhere faster. But still, it's really good to see this kind of momentum build up happening. And the reaction of the populace, you know, it's interesting. When I was doing, when I was canvassing for gay rights in New York City, there's a lot of assumptions, you know, about Europeans and such. It's like, oh, you know, some people would, you know, I would say, hey, do you have a minute for gay rights? Some people would pass me by. It's like, oh, it's okay. I'm from Europe. We already take care of that stuff. That was one of the responses. You know, that's a funny response, right? Because that's not true. Not really. Even worldwide, very, very few countries have so far have been pro-gay rights or have even legalized gay marriage. Marriage is just one proponent of the gay rights issue, but that seems to be the most talked about issue, the most controversial issue for some reason. But, I mean, the other issues, I mean, it's kind of hard to go against. But anyway, yeah, gay marriage is like this really driving issue. That's really interesting to see. It's quite, I don't know how to think about this. You know, that people in France just gathered together in a rally and protested the legislation that passed. And it's great to see that, you know, I mean, to see people, you know, rallying together and joining for a cause, even if it's for a cause that I am totally against. But this is democracy at work. You know, this is what happens. And, you know, while I disagree with them, you know, it's what it is, you know. But it's just, I just can't relate, is what I want to say. I guess this is why, you know, if I was on the other side, people doing like gay pride parades. If I was one of the people in the rally in France, if I was one of the people like save the sanctity of marriage in France, like this gay marriage legalization is going to ruin the concept of family in France. Save family. If I was one of those people, and I saw this spectacle of gay pride parade, I guess I wouldn't be able to relate. Like, what the heck are these people doing? Gay pride parade? What? So I guess looking at the opposite, like, I can't relate to these people saying, we gotta save the family in France, the concept of family in France. It's like, that makes no sense to me. I don't understand what the heck that's about. It's illogical, you know, gay marriage is not gonna ruin family in France. That's ridiculous. But it's just kind of interesting to see this movement happen. It's also a constant reminder that, you know, this is still a movement in its infancy. Gay rights, I mean, in many countries all around the world, it's actually illegal to be gay, much less gay married. Somewhere like Haiti, for instance, somebody could be beaten to death for being gay. And that's, you know, that's okay, apparently. I feel like, so there was one time I went as a canvasser, as a door canvasser, door-to-door canvasser. I went around this neighborhood in upstate New York. And the area I ended up in is a predominantly Haitian neighborhood. And the responses I got from, you know, the people that I knocked on their doors and started talking about why I was knocking on their door, let me tell you, that was quite something. I did not expect to encounter such, I want to say homophobia, like homophobic bigotry, the way I did when I was in that neighborhood. It was quite amazing. I mean, people were friendly, of course. I mean, they're not going to be super, you know, this is America. They're not going to beat me to death for talking about gay rights. But their opinions were, in my opinion, quite offensive. But it's just like, you know, what can you do? It's just like, okay, well, thank you for taking the time to talk with me. Have a nice day. Bye. You know, that was really bad. But, oh, man, I just can't relate. But it's amazing that people will gather together and think this is such a big, huge, gigantic issue to protest against. But it's really great to see this movement happening, to see, you know, not the movement about, you know, the protests, but the movement about gay rights and gay marriage becoming more widespread. France legalized it, Uruguay legalized it, I think it's New Zealand. I think Australia needs to, I don't know if Australia already did or not, but that's probably going to happen next. United Kingdom is still a big debate. I just can't wait till like this becomes a big, you know, thing that pushes outwards and homosexuality just becomes more and more accepted. And you know, if we can do homosexuality, then I can also hope for transgender and transsexual people. So it's step by step we're getting there towards equality. And man, I just wish it was moving faster and faster, but at least the momentum is there. So yeah, on to the next topic.